first topic of HRM, that is human resource management, meaning, scope, objective. So first we'll do this section. Okay, so let us start with the first. I'm starting with the introduction part. Okay, now introduction to human resource management. I have already discussed about human resource management earlier in detail. Today, as I am going through just a brief revision, so I'll be going through in a brief way. Okay, it would be in a brief manner. So HRM, what do you mean by human resource management? It is definitely related with the management of all the activities related to human resource in an organization, right? So HRM simply means that we will manage all the activities related to human. So what is human dimension? It is simply the employee or the people dimension in an organization. We all are aware, without human, we can never think of any organization to sustain. It is human, which actually men, we already have discussed about 4 M's in management, right? Earlier we have discussed about 4 M's, that is, without this men concept, means other 4 M, other 3 M will not work. We all are aware about the 4 M, right? In management, we have this 4 M. So men comes at the topmost priority, because ultimately this is men who manage the other factors, that is maybe machine or material or the money, right? Anything. So everything is controlled, monitored, planned, everything is done by men. So men forms the most important role here. So we need to understand that employee management or the human resource management, this people dimension forms a very important role for any organization, in any organization, right? So human resource management exists here so that we can actually optimally utilize our people. It is actual for the optimum utilization of our people. Like we have all our other resources. Simply, how we use our other resources? We would like to use it in an optimal manner. We have discussed in economics that how we can use our resources economically and optimally, isn't it? So human is also one of the most important resources. So without this, utilizing these resources efficiently, an organization can never grow properly, right? Now, human resource management is actually a process. Like any other management, means we all are aware that management is simply a process. We earlier discussed about the systems approach to management, right? What is systems approach to management? I'll just give you an insight about the same. What is systems approach to management? Systems approach. It simply means that management is a system. It's just like a computer where you provide input, then your processing is done, and then from that you will generate your output. The same way management also works. Like we have other systems like computer systems or any other system. Management is also a system. It works in a systematic manner where it depends on how I'm utilizing. The entire management is about this processing. Input can be same for me and you. It is possible that I and you are both, we both are using the same input. It is possible, right, that I'm also using the same input. You are also using the same input, but it depends on how I am making, processing the things, and on how you are processing the things. On means it all depends on our processing, right? How I am processing and how you are processing, it depends on our processing factor, right? So management is actually a systems. So processing consists of your what? Planning, then you have organizing, staffing, leading and controlling. These are there in our processing factor. Same way in human resource management also, HRM, human resource management, it consists of management of human resource activity. It is also a process where first we have to acquire, acquisition. Now again, if acquisition will start from, means how we will acquire? Actually, acquisition will definitely starts with a planning. Planning means the human resource planning that we'll go into details later on. So acquisition is the first point of action, normally we say. So HRM is a process consisting of acquisition. development, motivation, and retention. Now, these are few very small means. The terms are given in a very brief manner, but we know that acquisition consists of a lot of things. Development consists of a lot of things. Once you get into the details in depth, once we study in depth about the human resource development activities or how we motivate, there are a lot of factors in it, right? And then the retention is definitely very important task for any HR managers or the HR people to handle. So HRM process consists of the activities, which is acquisition, how we acquire, the entire process of getting human resource into an organization, development. It is all about how we can train our executives, develop them and motivate them. And then the ultimate process is retention. Now, retention is again, means a lot of factors influence our retention process, like how we treat our people, means how we treat our people, or you get a feedback. Suppose an organization wants to get the feedback of how they treat their employees. First of all, organizations are aware about how they are treating their employees. Still, sometime for a large organization, it is not possible for direct communication. Aisa ho sakta hai na, bade organization hai. Woh pe direct communication nahi ho paata hai. Directors or senior level management ke sang normal har employees ka coordination ya communication is not possible. Then in that case, normally exit interviews are the most important sources of feedback. Because from there we can understand, means performance appraisal is already means always there. Counseling interviews are there. But the most effective way is getting an exit feedback, because that time people is relieved from all the tension that yes, he is now nowhere a part of the organization, so he can freely express his views about the organization, right? So this is the entire process of HRM, and HR management must focus on all the process individually. Means every process is equally important. Either you acquire, you develop, motivate, and retention. Means all factors are equally important. Normally, you will find one factors lacking in most of the today's organization is retention factors. Organization does not think about the retention still now. Once we are having a knowledge-based organization, most of the organizations are knowledge-based organization. But tomorrow you are going to be an HR professionals or HR managers whatsoever after completing your MBA. So you should remember one thing very specifically, that retention is one of the most important part, which is still now ignored by most of the organization. People does not think of retention, and for that reason, they lose good employees, good potential employees, and even the best, sometimes best performers are not retained in good organizations. I'm not talking about small MSMEs or small scale organization. I'm talking about GIANs companies, MNCs. Even they are not taking care of their retentions properly, right? So you should take care of all these steps or all the processes individually. And we will be definitely going through it again. Functions of HRM. So what are the functions of HRM? Normally, human resource managers are, the functions of human resource managers are operated at two levels. One is the normal managerial function that everyone is supposed to do, that is planning, organizing, staffing, directing, that is leading and controlling. This is the normal managerial function which an HR manager is definitely supposed to do. Now this planning is about human resource planning. How means what would be the needs of the HR, and this needs of the HR or the planning for HR is synchronized with the strategic planning for the overall organizational planning. I'll just let you go through this. Okay. Suppose this is the organizational goals. This is the organizational goals. Organizational goals is somewhere going like this way. Now, organizational goals is somewhere going like this way. Now, my HR activities. HR should act like a facilitator, and it should prepare its HR strategies in a manner that it will facilitate in promoting or achievement of this goals. Right? This should be our focus, that we should achieve this goal. So HR strategy should be prepared. So HR department should plan all their activities or their strategies in accordance with the overall corporate goals or the overall organizational goals. So this is the first activities. Managerial activities, planning. then you will organize the staff according to the requirement, staffing, that is putting right people at right place at right time, and the another important factor is at right cost, which is ignored sometimes. So right cost is also important. Directing and controlling, right? These are the managerial function. Then you have operative function. Operative functions means what? For the HRM, what are the operative functions? That is directly for an HR department. The functions that directly relates with the HR activities. That is employment, human resource development, compensation and employee relations. These are the operative functions of human resource management. So human resource management mostly or is actually covered in, means they operate in this region only. The regions are employment, that they need to employ. That we, the acquisition comes in this part. Acquisition is the actually employment part. In the employment, we have the recruitment, selection, deployment, all these factors or all these phases are covered in employment. Okay, so employment covers all these sectors, sections, that is your recruitment part, how we'll get the good CVs, how to get good CVs, means whatever is required. Then your selection, interviews, then deployment, all this comes under employment part. Then the human resource development, training, assessing the training gap, training requirement for the employees, then accordingly giving them proper training, and the continuous evaluation, performance evaluation, and all this comes under the human resource development part. Learning and development, as we all know that today's competitive scenario, this human resource development is becoming all the way very important. It has to be taken care of. Even personal development, there should be some personal time given to employees so that they can develop, they can add on their education, their qualification or their skill, whatever is required. Not only according to their job, according to their skill, according to their knowledge, and also according to their willingness to do so. See, so these are the human resource development part. And then the compensation and employee relations. Compensation and employee relation actually comes under your motivation part. If we are compensated well, see, for me, if I'm getting salary on time, I'm very happy. My relations with other seniors, other peers, other colleagues are good. Employee relations are maintained very well. Then definitely I'm motivated to do that, means continue with that job. If somewhere I'm getting my compensation or getting my salary on time, bonus, everything is fine, but my social or the social factors or the employee relations are not good, HRs are not taking care, or the supervisors are not taking care of us, means any problems that occurs with us, any employee, then definitely there is some demotivating factors that will cope up. So it is very important that the motivation and the retention, because this compensation and employee relation, here only this is the part where employee feels motivated or demotivated, whether they would stay over here, retain, or they will retrench. Either you can retain them at this point of time. For this section, if you want to motivate and retain your staff, it is important that you take care of this. See, sometimes you say that giving a higher perks or higher salary is motivating. No, it's not that. Maybe giving salary on time, this is only the compensation or motivating factors for them, because they're getting salary on time. Because a brand for an organization, an employer brand is created once salary is created on time, you're giving them all the statutory benefit that is applicable to them. These are the few factors. It's not that it has to be very fancy. Your perks has to be very fancy. Even if you give the perks in a very just for a sustainable level, because it depends. If an employee is ready to work with you, then in any salary or in any compensation as at par with the market structure, definitely, then he will be happy if for whatever has been promised to him, he's getting that. An employee relation, the most important, the retention factor comes here. Employees feel that they should be listened, they should not be ignored. Actually, everyone likes to be listened. Everyone likes to be recognized. Everyone likes to be feel important. It's sort of things like that of thing. So employee relation comes here, and the retention factor is important. I have seen, you will find a lot of big companies. I will not say the name. I have faced the issues. I have seen many people are just, means this employee relations are thrown back somewhere. Employee relations are not there. And even if there are good employee relations with few managers, people would just feel that this should not be there, and they will just snatch you out of the organization. So this is the current scenario of Indian human resource management. So this is what is happening, and with big companies. So I think with this employee relation, there has to be certain HRD audit, which should be made mandatory at every level. Means at every level, there should be HRD audit should be done. Without HRD audit, many things are ignored or many things are not monitored properly. Because these are the function of HRM, human resource management. Now, maybe human resource manager is not aware of many things that is happening in an organization. And it is not possible for a department to handle maybe 1,000 staffs or maybe 10,000, 5,000, many number of, there are large number of organization and large number of people in it. So it is not possible for a single department to handle or to increase the motivations, to motivate the individual staff, or to increase the morale, increase the efficiency of each and every staff. It is not possible for the single department. So actually, human resource management is a type of activity which everyone must do. It is not for a single department. Human resource means everyone is dealing with human, right? If I am a supervisor of research department, so I am supervising a team of 10 to 20 people, then that means I am also managing the people. So for this employee relation or the human resource development, the focus should be that there should be a corporate strategy. There should be a top-down approach where the corporate strategies are prepared and the corporate strategies are implemented in a manner where managers are trained about human resource management activities, about the human relations, about employee relation, about human resources development. If this is ignored, then we cannot think of proper retention in any organization. So this is not whatever the roles we have discussed of the human resource management. So human resource management, this function is purely for HR department. Operative function like employment, HRD, compensation. Till this part is purely like compensation, nobody else is going to take care. But the employee relation or the retention part, the motivation and retention part must be taken care by all the managers and not only a single department. Right? Now the questions can come up like case, or you might have to write, aapko case de diya jayega, then you might have to observe the case and what are your suggestions, you have to write in your own manner. So it is important that you should observe everything. We will be going through the cases also, so that you can understand how to write the answers of the case. Okay. Now, emerging role of HRM. Now, there are certain roles that is emerging more of it. Means more, as I discussed earlier, only I said that this human dimension is becoming more important because of the increase, enhancement of the knowledge workers. Nowadays, we will not find only workers who are working in a factory. Now, most of the workers are knowledge workers. We are providing knowledge. We are providing services. We are not only producing product. People are not going door to door for selling. Telephonic selling are done. Online selling is done. So, definitely the trends of HRM will also change. People used to go to office daily. Means before this COVID situation, and after this IBM, Accenture and lot of IT companies came, means maybe for last 10 years back also I can relate that IBM and Accenture used to get this work from home project, and employee used to work from home, right? But this type of work from home scenario or work from home situation is quite new. As of now also for mid-sized companies, most of the companies in India, and that too in West Bengal, in Kolkata, the trend is not at all that. Yahan ka trend hai that your manager or your boss would like to see your face. Until unless he can see your face, he find that people are not working. This is the psychology of West Bengal, rather I'll say. So now the emerging role of HRM. Now the trend has changed because of this COVID. You cannot see the face means directly physically. It has to be a virtual meeting altogether. So the value of human resources is also increasing. Value of human resources. Human resource management dimension has been changed. Ultimately, we all know that the human resource management itself has changed. ये जो ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट है ना, ये ही बहुत ज्यादा चेंज हुआ है. ये पहले था पर्सनल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन, इट वॉज जस्ट मोर ऑफ एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन सॉर्ट ऑफ थिंग, देन इट केम्स टू द मैनेजमेंट एंड नाउ मोस्ट ऑफ द थिंग्स एंड नाउ वी आर अपग्रेडिंग मोर एंड मोर. आप देखो कोविड 19 सिचुएशन हैज ऑल्सो लेड टू अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स टू चेंज. ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट में बहुत सारी एक्टिविटीज चेंज हुई है. Many companies have adopted this, understood the new concept, and they have adopted this flexible approach towards working. उन लोगों ने adopt किया है, and that too it has several advantages like cost reduction, administrative expenses कम हो रहा है, giving a little bit of time means for people, and a lot of thing has happened. ठीक है, it has pros and cons as well. Now value of human resources, the companies, the organizations have identified that there is certain value of human resources. Human are treated as a capital now. Human resources are treated as a competitive advantage and not only a sources of factors of production. Nowadays, we not think human resource only as a factors of production. Now, human resources are a competitive advantage for us. Competitive advantage is like just your core competencies. हमने पहले देखा ना, core competencies means what? It's your competencies to differentiate yourself from the others. Competency, आपकी core क्षमता क्या है? बोलते हैं ना क्षमता, core क्षमता. तो competencies, what is differentiating you from the others, right? बुझते पहले, what is core competencies? Is this clear? मतलब you must have something which is differentiating you from Kostavi, right? Mopali, तुम्हारे कैसे किचु आचे जे तुम्हारे differentiate कोर्चे from Kostavi. Kostavi kache kichu ache that is differentiating from Shreya. So there is something different. So human resources are not only termed as employee, or they are not only treated as personal dimension. Now we are treating this as human resources. So we think of this as a competitive advantage. So we can have a competitive advantage. Competitive advantage, mere paas achhe staff hai. That is my competitive advantage. They are loyal, they are motivated, they will be with us. This is a competitive advantage. You go to Maruti, you will find everyone is working towards the same purpose. Maruti ke showroom mein jaiye, everyone is very much motivated, starting from the person who is opening the door till you, if you enter to the, even to the CEO, if you want to meet the CEO, he will also treat you in the same manner. Means customer is king. So, har koi ka face, everyone is representing the same face towards the customer with the same intention. Means they all are portraying the same strategy or ek hi jaisa bhai, sabki picture customer ke samne ek jaisi hai, same intention. So, ye kyun ho raha hai? Means human resources, yahan pe competing factor ho gaya mere liye, kyunki mere jo staff hain, they are quite motivated, their morale is very high, they are very much attached. So, isko hum log bolte hain effective commitment. If your effective commitment is high with the organization and your sincere, human resource can innovate, can come up with new research, can come up with new factors. So human resource jo factors hai wo ab sirf factors of production nahi hai, rather factor of production se bahut zyada increase ho gayi hai unki value. Theek hai, next emerging role for HRM is HR accounting. पहले हम लोग को लगता था HR is a qualitative thing, then how we can actually account for it. But nowadays, with the emergence of lot of softwares and lot of qualitative and quantitative factors in human resource, this human resources are made accountable. That means human resource activities are made accountable, which we call as human resource accounting. मतलब human resource जो भी काम कर रही है उसकी accounting, हिसाब. Accounting means you are accountable for. If you are incurring a CTC of 10 lakh rupees per head, so then what is the productivity of that staff? What we can expect means either you are contributing directly, if 10 lakh rupees is your CTC per year, then what is your contribution per year for the organization? 1 crore rupee hai aapki contribution, either you can contribute directly or indirectly. Agar indirectly hai to wo kis related hai? See, everyone is not, marketing is the marketing and sales, these are the function where we can calculate the productivity directly. The other functions which are integrated and coordinated in a manner which will help in marketing. See, everyone must work. As I said, ki har koi ko synchronized way mein kaam karna hota hai. Everyone's functions or everyone work is focused towards the same goal. Har koi ko ek disha mein hi kaam karna hota hai. ऑर्गेनाइजेशन का जो गोल है एवरीवन्स वर्क और एवरीवन्स स्ट्रैटेजीज फंक्शनल स्ट्रैटेजी शुड बी सिंक्रोनाइज्ड टुवर्ड्स द कॉर्पोरेट स्ट्रैटेजी. एचआर का अपना स्ट्रैटेजी, मार्केटिंग का अपना स्ट्रैटेजी, फाइनेंस नो इट्स नॉट पॉसिबल. एवरीवन शुड वर्क टुवर्ड द सेम गोल, राइट? एंड सो वी कैन कैलकुलेट इट आइदर क्वालिटेटिव और क्वांटिटेटिव, डायरेक्टली और इनडायरेक्टली. यू आर अकाउंटेबल एंड दिस अकाउंटेबिलिटी नीड्स टू बी कैलकुलेटेड एंड फॉर दैट the new role human resource management are expected to perform as the HR accounting factor. So accounting aspect has been added on it. Next, the most important is human resource analytics. Analytics today's and in today's world, analytics form the very important role. Everywhere, whenever we talk about data. Har jagah par jahan bhi baat karo aap data. So whenever we talk about, think about any type of decisions, kuch bhi decision lena hai, either of appraising a investment proposal or taking a staff retrenchment, retention, anything, whatever you plan of downsizing, increasing, merger, acquisition, kahin par bhi aap baat karo, we will first talk about this analytics, that is data, data management. Analytics is nothing but though it is actually a gameplay of all data. Data ko kis tarike se hum use karenge in decision making process. This is what analytics role is. The human resource mein analytics kya karega? Yahan par aap sabse zyada agar data management kahin par hota hai, it is there in human resource or finance. Ye do hi ek department hai jahan pe sabse zyada data ko lekar kaam hota hai. There are a lot of numerous data. Now with this numerous data, how to synchronize and how to फिल्टर द डेटा, यू नीड टू कंडेंस द डेटा. इतनी सारे डेटा हैं, मतलब अननेसेसरी बहुत सारे डेटा हो सकते हैं. तो एनालिटिक्स विल हेल्प यू आउट टू गेट द प्रॉपर इन्फॉर्मेशन एट द राइट टाइम सो दैट वी कैन टेक द प्रॉपर डिसीजन. जैसे अगर मुझे डिसीजन लेना, आई वुड लाइक टू डाउन साइज माई करेंट वर्क फोर्स स्ट्रक्चर, देन डेफिनेटली आई टेक केयर ऑफ माई करेंट प्रोडक्टिविटी रेट, quality of my workforce, what is my quality of workforce, what is their productivity, what is the CTC I am paying, lot of things are there. So how will I get all the data? And if I get this all this data in a visualized form, visual agar hoga na, agar aap graph mein hoga ya bar graph mein, histogram mein, frequency chart mein, kisi bhi tarike se, to aap pie chart mein ho, kaise bhi ho, to data jab visualized rehta hai to hame bahut easy hota hai koi bhi decision lena. To HR analytics ka yahi kaam hota hai. यहाँ पर एचआर रिलेटेड जितने भी इंफॉर्मेशन हैं, उसको हम लोग एनालिटिक्स या विजुअलाइज रूप में हम लोग इन अ विजुअलाइज फॉर्म वी क्रिएटेड सो दैट वी कैन टेक प्रॉपर एचआर रिलेटेड डिसीजन. अब देखो एचआर रिलेटेड डिसीजन में एचआर एनालिटिक्स क्यों उतने इंपॉर्टेंट है. सिंपल सी बात है, ह्यूमन रिसोर्स फैक्टर ना, आपको पता होगा पहले फैक्ट्रीज में स्ट्राइक होती थी. एम्प्लॉय को अगर आपने रिट्रेंच कर दिया या कोई फैक्ट्री बंद कर दी तो स्ट्राइक हो जाती थी. So we can understand that either retrenchment, downsizing, laying off, these are a very important decision for any organization to take. So before taking any such decision, they should have proper data supporting the decision they are taking. So uske liye HR analytics bahut important role play karta hai, theek hai? Next is human capital management. Now what is human capital management? People possesses innate abilities, behaviors, and personal energy, and these elements make up the human capital they bring to their work. And this is, and it is they, not their employees, who own this capital and decide when, how, and where they will contribute it. देखो, यहाँ पर क्या बताया जा रहा है? Human capital management क्या? पहले human capital क्या? We all are human, and we have our own abilities, we have our own skills, behaviors, all these things, and we are bringing all these things means. जब मैं किसी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में हूँ तो ये सारी चीज, मेरे जो भी स्किल्स हैं, मेरे बिहेवियर्स हैं, मेरे स्ट्रेंथ है, मेरे वीकनेस है, वो सारी चीज मेरे कैपिटल में है. मैं एक ह्यूमन हूँ, आई एम एन एम्प्लॉय और आई एम ए ह्यूमन, एंड ऑल दिस एबिलिटीज और डिसेबिलिटीज जो भी होगा, अगर मेरी जो भी अपने इननेट एबिलिटीज हैं, बिहेवियर्स हैं, पर्सनल एनर्जीज हैं, ऑल दिस आर कंट्रीब्यूटिंग, आई एम कंट्रीब्यूटिंग ऑल दिस फैक्टर्स टू माई वर्क, राइट? सो वॉट एवर आई विल हैव, आई विल give this towards my organization. I'll contribute with all my skills. देखो, जब मैं किसी organ, मैं एक employee हूँ, so I am a human capital for my employer. एक employer को समझना पड़ेगा, he is not employing an employee only. वो एक human capital को employ कर रहा है. He or she is, means an organization is actually taking a human capital for which they are paying salary, जो भी दे रहे हैं. बट ह्यूमन जो है वो कैपिटल के रूप में किस तरीके से काम करेगा? देखो हर ह्यूमन के अंदर कुछ ना कुछ इननेट एबिलिटीज हैं, स्किल्स हैं, बिहेवियर्स हैं, उनके अपनी लेवल ऑफ एनर्जी है। हर कोई के अंदर जो जितना भी खराब रहे उसके अंदर कुछ ना कुछ स्किल्स तो रहेगा ही, कुछ ना कुछ तो स्ट्रेंथ है, एंड दैट इज व्हाई यू हैव टेकन द एम्प्लॉयज, राइट? तो इट इज अप टू द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन हाउ दे कैन मेक एफिशिएंट यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ दैट ह्यूमन रिसोर्सेज। सो आप कैपिटल को किस तरह से मैनेज कर रहे हो? मेरे पास बहुत कैपिटल है इन टर्म्स ऑफ मनी, पैसे बहुत पड़े हुए हैं, बट आई डोंट नो हाउ टू यूज इट। मैं गई शॉपिंग कर ली, देन आई यूज्ड इट, एग्जॉस्टेड इट, बट रादर इफ आई इन्वेस्टेड इट समवेयर इन अ प्रॉपर वे, देन डेफिनेटली इट विल गिव मी मोर रिटर्न्स, बेटर रिटर्न्स। सो इट इज ऑल अबाउट माई मैनेजमेंट ऑफ माई कैपिटल। सो ह्यूमन कैपिटल मैनेजमेंट इज द सेम थिंग, इट डिपेंड्स ऑन हाउ यू मैनेज योर ह्यूमन कैपिटल, राइट? दिस इज द फर्स्ट टॉपिक वी हैव कवर्ड।